We can actually use Photoshop for 3D printing. I teach you how in this awesome guide. Stick around. So this will be the 3D model that we'll be making in Photoshop. It is pretty simple, 3D print time extruded, and it's a very simple model to build in Photoshop. I will teach you how in the following steps. Creating the typography is pretty easy. I use a font called Sans Serif Pro Black. It's a beautiful font, a beautiful sans serif, and as you can see in the video, I'm kerning it, I'm just resizing it to something that looks pretty good. Make sure that each element will be on its own layer. So that way, when we go to the 3D view, we can select each layer independently. Of course, I'm speeding through it because it's pretty easy Photoshop work. So we can have more time working on the more interesting stuff. The second step is to create these support beams. And that will just help the 3D model to be more stable when it finally prints. As you can see, the support beams are red, so you can easily see them apart from the type. When 3D printed, it will be the same color as the rest of the plastic. Ultimately, we're going to create three layers for the support beams, one for each word. And make sure you name it something logical, such as 3D support, so that way we can easily find it later on. Now that we are done with all the 2D elements, we can finally do some fun stuff in 3D. Woohoo! Once we have all the 2D layers, we need to make 3D extrusions out of them. This is very simple. All you need to do is right-click the layer and select New 3D Extrusion from Selected Layer. And bang! I'm gonna speed this video up to do the same to all the other layers. Once we got that, we can move to the next step. The next step is very important, because if you don't do that, you will not be able to 3D print the entire sculpture. You can merge the 3D layers by selecting every 3D layer you got and go to 3D Merge Layers, and presto. As you can see, it merged every 3D layer into one 3D layer, which also makes it a lot easier to navigate with your camera. Okay, let's go to the 3D panel and select 3D Print and Time. We move over to the Properties panel and change the extrusion depth to 2 inches. And this looks mighty fine. Of course, we need to do the same thing to our support elements. So we need to select 3D support, print, and time support. And we do the same thing, except we change the extrusion depth to 0.5 inches. And this looks good to me. Now we need to align all the elements together. And that is pretty easy to do. To do that, we need to select all the support elements. Let me move them out of the way. And then go up on the top bar and press center align. Awesome. Now let's do the same thing with the typography too. Let's move the support bars so they just touch the edge of the typography. Let's take a look how the sculpture looks on the front. We can see that some of the support beams did not align properly, so let's quickly fix it by moving the support beams into the right places. You can see, as we rotate the 3D, the support bar does not move with it. For that to happen, we need to group the 3D support bar to the 3D typography element. And we can do that by simply dragging and dropping it into the folder. Now you can see, as we rotate the 3D type, the support bar rotates as well. Let's speed through that for the other two support beams. Since we want to stack the type, let's scale them a little bit down, make them a little bit thinner on each top, like a pyramid. This is easily done by scaling just the Z-axis on print and 3D. Of course, on the top, we also scale the Z on just the 3D. let's go rotate 3D and print on the y-axis to make it a little bit more funky, more interesting. Also, let's move just the 3D on the y-axis, but let's rotate it in the opposite way to make it look like very uneven stacked boxes. Move the camera on the front and let's nudge it a little bit downwards so 3D and print and time, so they all touch each other. This is important because these are the areas that's gonna fuse once we 3D print that item. We are so close of being done with Photoshop. All we need to do is export the STL file and we are done. But there's a right way and a wrong way of doing it. And let me show why. The wrong way of doing it is by right-clicking the 3D layer and press Export 3D Layer. Initially, it looks pretty good, but the problem arises later on when it tells us the actual dimension of the document, which, as you can see, our file is not 133 inches wide. It does not make any sense. This is what the file would look like in Cura, for instance, when you place it in. Way too huge. So we need to do it a different way. The correct way of exporting the STL file for 3D printing is by going to the 3D tab at the very top bar, 3D print settings, and this will bring us into the 3D settings. Now when we go to the properties, we can now select local. Now when we go to 3D, 3D print, it will now give us the proper STL file for our preferred slicer. Now we're getting a last minute view of what the 3D file looks, and we can immediately see it's 6 inches times 5 inches times 2 inches. This looks awesome. Let's export it, the STL, and bring it to our preferred slicer. Okay, I got Makerware open, so all we need to do is press Add File and import the right STL file. And here we go. Move to platform is fine. And there it is. Let's check our settings real quick. Looks good to me. And let's press export. Let's press export now. One thing to note is that Makerware is extremely slow at slicing. This little 3D file took me 16 minutes to slice. On the lower right corner, you see Cura in real life slicing the same file. It took only seconds. So I loaded the 3D files into my 3D printer and let's print it. And as you can see, let's go for it. So I chose Makerware to slice because it allowed me to do dual prints. But the only bad thing is I forgot how much the support material is glued to it. To get rid of all of that, it took me literally 1 hour to do, and I cut my hand several times pretty badly doing it. So I would definitely not recommend that. I would definitely stick with Cura. Cura just offers you a lot more options how to go about applying the support material, while Makerware is kind of simple. Let's spray print the 3D print to hide some imperfections. And I think the 3D print is pretty much done. Awesome. So here's the physical 3D print part. Pretty neat, huh? If you liked that video, please like, subscribe, and comment below. I really appreciate it. This is especially important for a young YouTube channel such as mine to keep me, you know, motivated to keep going. So thank you so much for your support. Take it easy.